Hello, everyone. Welcome to this edition of Two Broke Guys, where we're going to talk about the Flamingo, which was very popular in the 1950s and even the 1960s. It came from traveling, where people were going on vacation a lot, probably to Florida and areas like that, and overseas, of course, to the islands. And I'd like to talk to you about the color pink. It's not uncommon, of course, if you're a collector of the vintage items of the 1950s, to find a lot of items in pink. And for some reason, there wasn't as many people afraid of that color as there are today. We tend to shy from it. I mean, even men's clothes were pink, and it wasn't a big deal to wear them. This is a very nice piece. A lot of people like these. And they are Maddox by Maddox of California. A lot of pieces were made in California. And here's a little planter. And I don't know who the maker is of that. And you'll see right here, these pink flamingos, which a lot of times came in a little pond. So if you guys ever see the pond without the flamingos, and you ever see this piece right here, and you think, well, that's weird, what's that for? That's what it's for. The flamingos, people would put them in there. I didn't know that till later. I used to see these by themselves, you know, and I'd be like, well, that's a cute, you know, vintage dish, but I didn't really understand it. I thought maybe it was a chip dip or something like that. Chip and dip bowl, I mean. And the flamingos go in it. Also, I believe this is, try not to break my stuff here. I can't really read it. Oh, goodness. I can't read it, guys, but it's made in California. And you'll see the pond there. Some of them are pink inside and some of them are green. This needs to be cleaned. A lot of dusting. Here's a big white one right here. I like this piece a lot. And I didn't realize that. Hold on a second. Remove this. There you go. When I bought it, I thought it was perfect, but it has been glued or it's fractured right there, but I can't, you know, it's not enough to really, I mean, who cares, you know, it's together and that's awesome. I just loved it. So I had to have that. Now, I'd like to show you this. If you see these big pictures with the flamingos on them, they're pretty coveted. They're pretty nice pieces. And if you look closely, you'll see glitter. That's glitter up inside of them. The sparkles, they loved glitter back in the 50s. A lot of pieces have glitter in it and gold. They liked gold a lot. You'll see that is the original frame. Look at the artwork. As I was mentioning about the color pink, here is a shirt from that era, the 50s, I believe, rockabilly style. It's a man's shirt. It's a Western shirt. But nevertheless, I thought it was awesome. And you can see the little atomic print in there. You know, the shiny threads. Little pearl snap buttons. Thought it was awesome, and it fits me pretty well, like that. And this apron that I made with some vintage fabric. I know, but I thought it was cool. Because that's some old fabric that I actually found in an old house. And I found this and sewed it onto there, these straps. And do I wear it? Not as much as I should, but I don't mind. I think it's kind of cool. So yes, guys, pink is a very common color in the 1950s, as well as the pale blue and the teal. They all put it together. There's the famous, iconic flamingo, 1950s. If you like this video, please subscribe and hit the bell button for newer videos. and if you like vintage items from the 40s, 50s, and 60s. Thank you so much for watching.